Yay! Okay. Okay, so y'all sit on this. Okay. Okay. All right, you ready for story time?
Let me know when y'all are ready.
Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna read y'all a story about Jennifer's life.
Okay?
So this book is called Jennifer, Who is Kind of Awesome.
Wow.
Okay. Once upon a time, there was a gift to the world, and a little girl named Jennifer Long, or J-Lo, or Jenny Jo, or Jennifer, was born. Do you think her last name is Long because of her long second toe?
Yeah.
You do? Okay.
I do.
Okay. She loved reading notes that her dad put in her lunchbox. This is her as a baby. He would write notes like, you are smart, you are kind, and you are important. It is. That's her when she was a baby. Yeah. Okay, go sit back on your mat. Uh-huh.
This is her.
Yep. Yep. She even loved helping him play in the school sometimes.
I have one of those too.
Okay.
I do.
All right. She didn't have any brothers or sisters, but she did have lots of friends. Packed the house with people. She was never shy about her surroundings because she knows that loving people is far more important than the walls around us or our beliefs. And she was able to put on a bright protective raincoat when times were tough. Yeah, that's a bright protective raincoat.
See?
No. Uh-huh. Okay. And speaking of love, she loved a game called...
Yellow?
It is. She loved a game called, do you know what that game's called? Softball. She was a leader on the team and could read the field, her coach's signals, her teammates, her own intentions of where to put the ball, and how hard to throw it, all at the same time.
Coaches.
It is, that's her.
Coaches.
Yes. Yep. And then, she was in college for
5 days.
The doctors took out 2 feet of his colon. That's as long as a jump rope. And so she came home to help. At this time, she might have felt like a little blue fish in a deep blue sea. She knows that taking care of family is very important. Jen found what makes her heart glow. Kids! Uh-huh. She took care of kids who needed extra help and listening and staying safe. She was always patient, observant, and gentle. And then she also takes care of, who's that?
Mona.
Uh-huh, Otis and Ramona. They sing songs together, learn how to share their feelings together, play Old Lady Who Swallowed a Fly together, build bonfires and play on playgrounds. They eat apples and look for bugs. Kindness is at the heart of all of her interactions.
That's my apple.
Did you eat that one?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you find that worm?
No.
Okay. She is also known as a talented seeker and finder. I imagine, wait one second, that if we were all walking through a hot sandy Sahara, she'd be the one who could spot the oasis. She can find a striking image, a truth, and exactly what people are looking for. So this is the seeker and finder chipmunk. You also might find her playing with Coco.
I'm
checking to make
that.
Sure that her house is secure.
I made that.
You did?
Yeah.
Cool. You might find her wearing an uplifting motivational t-shirt or decorating for the holidays, or being with her friends like Heidi or Courtney, driving her silver car down Brown's Ferry Road and singing to a good song. She says, wear your heart on your sleeve. And that's a tie-dye shirt with a heart on the sleeve. And remember when we went to the pumpkin patch?
Yeah.
That was so fun.
Was they even?
Uh-huh. She knows that all things, her feelings, other people's feelings, the sky, is many shades of all colors. This is how she was able to empathize. Your shoes are her shoes. Now, usually, the end of the book means the story's over, but this is a unique story. Jennifer's story is certainly not ending. She turns 30 years old this year and has lots of openness to what life brings her way. It could be. She rises and shines just like the morning sun around the Tennessee River Bend. She is loved by all through all the seasons. by Go Through What You Go Through Productions. Copyright 2021. Mm-hmm. Thanks for listening.
Now can we play on the playground? Yes,
we can play on the playground.
Yeah!
The day you were born was one of the happiest days of my life. And we have just enjoyed watching you grow and become the woman you are today. You're one of the most kind and compassionate and loving women that I've ever known. Your compassion for others never ceased to amaze me. We've enjoyed watching you play sports, whether it be softball or volleyball or basketball. It's just been an amazing time, a wonderful family time that a lot of people don't get. And we've been so thankful for that. We're especially thankful that you're looking to get healthy, and what you're doing in your life is how you're working out and just becoming a better you is even more astonishing to me to watch you as you evolve and change. And just, I'm excited to see what the next few years are going to be like and what God calls you to do. And I guess if there was anything I could say is just continue seeking God and what He has for you in your life, because you do have a servant's heart, and that is a gift. And I just love you so much. Happy birthday.
Well, Jen, happy birthday. It's kind of a surprise. You know that I don't do this very well, but you know, you have been a blessing in our lives. And as an older father, I learned a lot from that experience. I raised a lot of kids before you and thought that I knew everything there was. But you don't ever know what it's like until you have your own child. I mean, you made a big difference in my life and everybody else's. Often I have people say good things about how well that they appreciated how we took care of their kids through the years. And I have to give you credit for that. I would never let a kid come into my center that I wouldn't treat like I would my daughter. So the fact that you were part of me and part of my life has helped everybody else too. And I can't say enough, you know, you've always been daddy's girl. I don't know if you'll ever have perfect attendance like you did the first 6 years of school, me taking you in all the time. But I know that wherever you're going, whatever you're going to do, it's going to be very successful. You have a lot of your mom, which is a wonderful trait. And you have a lot of me. So you're wired in a different way. So when you get all confused sometimes, you understand where that comes from. And that's not a bad thing. The Lord has blessed us and He blessed you. We had waited a long time for you. And we just went today to a service of a lady who had a large part in praying for you to arrive in this world. And what a wonderful thing that is that we can experience this with you. And I don't know how I could tell you I could love you more. If you hadn't seen it by now, then you're probably never going to know. But I'll always be with you, no matter what. You know I'm an older dad, and I know that's frustrating because you feel like, well, you know, that might be a setback, but it's not, and everything's going to be fine. And you'll always have me in every way. I hope you have a wonderful birthday, and we're going to continue to celebrate this throughout the rest of your life, not just on the 30th.
For a couple weeks, I only want to see her. We think away the days with the takeaway pizza before it's Christmas.
Jen! With two N's.
Jen. Of course, my video is going to be coming from the car, naturally. Where do you think it's going to be coming from? That's the stuff that we always used to do. We'd always just hang out, go for a ride, jam out to some Ed Sheeran or some Rihanna. You know how we do? Jen, with two N's. 30 years old. Girl, how you gonna be that old? Huh? I just wanna tell you, happy birthday. 30 years old, you're older than me. Always will be, so you're an old woman. I'm always young and beautiful. So, just letting you know how that's gonna be. I just want to talk about all the things we used to do. You know, how many times did I text you late at night after the sunset? Like, hey, let's just go for a ride. Let's go drive around, listen to some music. you were one of the first people that I ever came out to. You absolutely had a hand in getting my precious little baby puppy, Shaggy. You were with me when I got Shaggy. We have known each other for almost 10 years at this point, and you are absolutely one of my best friends, one of the greatest people that I have ever met, one of the nicest and most genuine people in this world. And I just want you to have the best birthday because, girl, you deserve it. Happy birthday, Jen. I love you.
Okay. Jennifer, she is my granddaughter. She is my friend. We have great times together. She's a great road tripper. We've been on several road trips. And, you know, if I need anything or I want to go somewhere, all I have to do is call her. And she knows that if she needs me, she can call me at the last minute and say, Grandma, I need you. And, you know, there I am. So anything we do, we seem to always have fun. We watch football games. Sometimes football games, but softball games. And go to eat. We can even have fun eating, because the other night she had ordered chicken strips and it was taking forever to get them. And she said something about, well, and I said, well, maybe they had to go get Wanda. She looked at me like, huh? And then she realized it was one of her chickens. So we had a good laugh over that. So it's just, we have a good time anywhere we go. And she is so big-hearted and tender and very easy to get embarrassed. So I hope I'm not embarrassing her, but she knows how much I love her.
Hi, Jennifer. Just laying in the sun for a few minutes in this beautiful day on Easter Sunday. I'm thinking about you, and Monica put this awesome little video thing together, and I just wanted you to know how much I love you and respect you. Jen, you are the funniest and sweetest and most loving person I think I know. You exude love to others. You love well, and I am the recipient of that a lot of times, and so are my grandkids. I can't even begin to tell you how fortunate Otis and Ramona are to have had you to start their life with all the beginnings, their alphabet, their numbers, but mostly, how much you love and care for them. Honestly, Jen, sometimes I'm jealous that you get to do so many things with Otis and Ramona, and I am out working doing the same things with other children who are not my grandchildren. But I am so happy and so blessed that you're in our life, that you've been there for them and you're there for us. I am so excited to be on this journey with you and see the woman of God that you are becoming and the new woman that you're going to be. It's going to be an amazing adventure, and it's going to be hard, but realize that we are with you all the time, in spirit or with you. Eating and not drinking and not eating cake and not eating fun stuff that we love to do. But you know, life is so much more than that. And we know that, and you know that. And I am excited to see this journey begin for you. We will be praying every day for you. You know it. I love you, Jen.
Yeah, say cheese.
Cheese.
No, it's a video. Say happy birthday.
Cheese.
No, say happy birthday.
Cheese. Oh.
It's Jen's birthday.
Say happy birthday, Jen.
I love you.
I love you.
You're the best cousin ever.
Forever.
Along with Otis and Mona.
Mona.
And Otis. And I wish you happy birthday, Jen.
Birthday, Jen.
One last love you.
Blower kisses.
Yeah.
Yeah, blower kisses.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, Jen. I just wanted to say how much you mean to me and how grateful I am for our friendship. And I was thinking back of all the things that we've shared together and we've been through, and how much I love having you and all the memories of high school and playing ball together, and how special that was, and how we've been neighbors and how much fun that has been. But I'm just so thankful for our friendship now and where we are, almost 30. And how excited I am that Milo will have you as Auntie Jen. But I love your kind spirit and how I can count on you as a friend and that you're always there for me. And I hope that you know that I will be here for you as well. But just wanted to say how much I love you and how thankful I am for our friendship.
Hey, Jen, this is your favorite uncle. And I remember when Jimmy comes walking down the hall at the hospital, and he's got this little baby in his arms and got this little pink hat, and he was as proud as he could be. Well, I'll never forget that. And now you're grown up, and I'm so glad that you are taking care of my grandkids. Because I know they're well taken care of, and you love them like no other, and we really appreciate you. And by the way, thanks for the sunglasses you bought me. But I just want to say we'll be praying for you. We love you, and you're not to worry. Everything's going to be good. Good luck. I love you.
What's up, Jen? Happy birthday. I'm so glad that I got to know you and get to know you and love you. And you're honestly one of the best people I've ever met, for sure. And truly, I hate that we don't get to spend as much time together anymore. So just some things I love about you. You're one of the most loyal people I have ever known. You're just consistent. You're loving, you're kind, you're accepting. Like, there was nothing I told you that would even faze you, you know? You were the first person that contacted me after my dad died. You were there for me during all that. And like, holy cow, you're just a fucking solid human, man. I love you so hard. And I really hope that we can start spending some more time together, because you're one of my best friends and my favorite people to hang out with. I'll never forget, my mom used to think we were out smoking cigarettes driving around, and really we were just going to Sonic trying to be cool in your car because you could drive and I couldn't because I was still a baby. But man, I loved that. That was awesome. And I think probably one of the funniest things that ever happened was when you got your license and you got that new car. And we spent all that time, you know, like scrubbing it with a toothbrush. And then I guess we were trying to go to Waffle House, and that dude like smacked into the side of the car. I thought we were going to die. It was really scary then, and actually kind of scary for a little while after. I was a little shaken up, but that is so funny. I think about that every time I pass through that intersection, which is often, in fact. But yeah, man, I love you so much. I'm so glad you were born. I'm glad we get to celebrate you, and I just love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. I hope you have the best birthday in the world, and here's to another year on this planet doing this stuff. Love you. Happy birthday.
One of my favorite memories of Jennifer is when we were in high school and during study hall, we weren't supposed to be in the same room, and Miss Deer always caught us and had to separate us. Good times there, Jen. But another one of my favorite things is watching Jennifer grow up from what she was like in high school to the 30-year-old that she is now. So it's been fun watching you grow up, Jen. You've become one of my best friends, and I don't know what I'd do without you. So I love you. Happy birthday.
Hey, Jen.
Hey, Jen.
We just wanted to tell you that we love you so much, and we're so grateful for everything you do for the kids. I love that you love the kids with all your heart, and I'm so grateful for how much you do for them. And I'm especially excited right now of how much you have been doing for yourself lately, because you do give them so much, and I'm really glad to see you and how healthy you've been lately. And it's inspiring to me. It makes me want to be healthy, and I really appreciate that you're being that influence for all of us in our lives.
And Jen, I've seen you through lots of birthdays, and now to see it through on the 30th and at this stage in all of our lives, I just couldn't be happier to call you family. And as much as family means to this family, you know what that means and what it represents. I just really appreciate about you how your decisions are thought through, acted through, and honored throughout a season of life. Everything that you've ever done, you've always committed yourself to it and dedicated yourself until you knew it was the end and time to move on. And that's something great for just a great role model for our kids, and how much you love them and how much they love you right back, that's for sure. We love you, proud of you, proud of everything that you're doing now.
Hi, Jenny. It's Kenny. I just wanted to tell you happy birthday, and I love you so much. One of the reasons I love you so much is how genuine and optimistic you are about everything. Obviously, that's one of the reasons I picked you to be one of my bridesmaids. You kept me grounded, because we all know how not grounded I can be. And I just hope that you realize how much we all love you and how grateful we are for you. I would tell stories about us, but a lot of them are not repeatable, as we both know. But most of them involve us having a great time driving up to the Raccoon Mountain beside your house and driving anywhere, really. Driving to ghost places that Taylor would make us go, and I would be crying in the back of the car. Anything with you was fun, and that is why I love you, Jen, and why I think we'll be friends forever. And of course, I have to do this. Snow, love you.
Hello, I just wanted to take some time to tell you how much I appreciate you, and I'm so glad that you become part of the family. Not only did my mom gain a bestie, but we gained an additional aunt J-Lo. She's awesome. I just wanted to say that you're the bomb.com, and I'm so glad that I have you in my life. I can't tell you how much I appreciate you and just kind of being there for me and always giving me advice and always being so like down to do anything and like being there for my mom, because you and her are like two peas in a pod and go great together. And I'm so glad that you have each other and then that we have you. And I couldn't imagine doing life without you. And trust me, if I get in trouble at UTK, you're going to be the first phone call. So anyway, love you and happy birthday.
Hey, J-Lo. Thanks for coming to my games and coming over and having fun. I appreciate it. And keeping my mom busy so she doesn't pester me. Thanks.
Hey, Jim. Hope you're having a great day. Hope it's a fun day. Just want to say I love you, and I'm so excited for you. This transformation, this journey you're on, it's powerful, it's exciting, and inspiring. You really have had an impact on my life, and I'm so much older. You're one of the kindest, most compassionate, non-judgmental, caring individuals I have ever met, and that is so contagious. People that are in search for the truth, what the truth is, what's inside of them, really look to people like you. And hey, it's a gift you have. Remember the gift. I was thinking about how many funny moments we've had, and there's been so many, because every time we've been together, even when we've been talking about something deep, we find the playfulness in it. And that just makes me so happy, because then the message and the love and the connection between us is always relayed, you know, properly and sticks. So with that being said, I'm gonna leave you with a song, because really this is the message that I would always want to leave with you, and doggone it, just messed the stupid thing up. Okay, here we go. Dang it. Hold on. You gotta talk to yourself like someone you love, girl. Memorize these lyrics. I love you, Jen.
J-Lo.
Man, I can't even imagine life without you, Jay. You came into my life when I needed you the most during a pretty hard time for me, but you always, always seem to find the positive, and that's what I just love about you so much. Even though this year has been super, super tough for you, and you've had lots of trials and stuff, you've just continued to push on and persevere and just, you know, get it. Look how far you've come just in a year. You look amazing. You feel amazing. And of course, you are amazing. And I just love you so much. And just thank you for always giving me grace, even when I don't need it sometimes, because I can be just a big butt. But you're always there when I need you. You're somebody that I can always count on no matter what. And even if I don't talk to you, I know that you're thinking of me, and I'm always thinking of you too. My family just loves you to death. We'd be lost without you. Jay, you just keep on being you. And even though you've got some stuff coming up, we're always going to be there for you. And you know what? I just can't wait to see how the next couple months, you know, what they have in store for you, because I just can't wait, because I know it's going to be something great, because you're great. So, Jay, I love you. I love you to the moon and back. Jarnar, I just need you forever and ever. And you know what? We've got a lot of living still to do together. So just keep on being you, Jay, and I'll just keep on being me. And you know what? We're just going to be great together. Love you, girl.
Jen, I know Avon and I haven't known you as long. Pun intended, as everyone else in the video, but I can say this year of such unpredictability, you have been our angel of kindness. You gave us both flexible and comfortable friendship in a time of social distancing and crazy toddler moments. You gave us a judgment-free safe zone in the most humbling year of my life. You gave us flower in the forest joy in a time of pandemically proportioned heaviness. You gave us someone to swing with, swim with, read with, and play with. And by watching Avon on Tuesdays, you've given me time to start to rebuild. And through all this, you have been faced with a personal health challenge of your own. Learning that an organ of your body isn't functioning as it should is really scary. But gosh, the way you've faced it has been so admirable and brave. I've never seen someone so earnestly evolve as you have. But it makes sense. You've been putting in the effort, reinvesting in yourself for years by seeking various wisdoms, practicing listening to yourself and your needs, enacting love for all generations. So, at this point in your life, I just wanted to take a moment to help you feel how much of a gift you are, not just to Avon and myself, but to your family, friends, neighbors, and the world. And not just now, but as you are, as you have been, and as you will be.
One memory we wanted to remind you of is just remember that you were so prayed for, and we waited 3 whole years for you. And the day you were born, there were 30 people in the waiting room just rejoicing at your birth, because it was an answer to prayer, many prayers. So
when Pam was sitting back in the back room, I was carrying you out to the crowd to show you off for the very first time, and we had a big pizza party. And I've never seen so many pictures taken in my entire life.